Hello and welcome to Sports Gaming Universe channel here on YouTube, and welcome back to the Rob Blanchflower Connected Franchise or Connected Career Series here in Madden 15. Yet we're still working on our EA Access 6-hour time limit here, so I went ahead and tried to record another Rob Blanchflower episode for you. Now remember, he is a third string tight end, and we are entering the first week of play here, so I don't know how much time he's going to see on the field. For right now, we're building up his XP and trying to get him into maybe that second string spot where he gets a lot more time on the field. Right now, it's a lot of extra points. It's a lot of kickoffs. It's a lot of special teams in general. Now, to this point, I've made the decision not to make him the auto starter. Obviously, that's a choice in your options. You can set your player to be an auto starter, and we could get to the meat and potatoes of this right away. Now, I'm going to talk to you guys later about our options about that. But for right now, we're getting ready for the season opener, which also happens to be the home opener against the Cleveland Browns. Pretty good matchup right here, as these two rivals will take on each other in week one. Let's go to the presentation and check this out.
Hello, everybody. I'm Larry Ridley, and this is the NFL on EA Sports. It's a fresh start throughout the league here in week one, as these two teams have high hopes for the season ahead. So let's go now to Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania, where Jim and Phil are on the call.
The opening week of the National Football League has finally arrived.
Hello, friends. Jim Nance along with Phil Simms. And Phil, it's the start of a whole new season. There's a sense of renewal in the air and all kinds of hope. And how do you feel about getting this season underway?
Well, I think you're right. It is a lot of hope for all the teams in the NFL, but also what you have in a game like this, opening day, you have nerves. So it's up to the coaches to really put the players in situations where they can get involved in the game and get rid of those nerves so they can show everything they worked on this offseason can work.
The Browns are back deep, waiting for the kick return. And Sean Sweezum looks ready to get this one underway.
All right, since Madden 15 is brand new, I wanted to just kind of show you the pregame presentation a little bit. Make sure to get that in there. So now we kind of play the waiting game and wait to see when Blanchflower hits the field. It will be on kickoff return team right here. Cleveland scores first, makes it 7-0. And so here we go. You can see him out blocking out front, kind of getting tangled up in the mess there, and really not much going on. Like I said, a lot of special teams right now for a third string tight end. He's not going to get on the field all that often unless they need breathers or they actually go to a three tight end set, which we're not going to see very often. So Roethlisberger comes to the field right here to get his team going. First time they have their hands on the ball. And when will we get in here next? Okay, this really confused me here. I should have looked a little more carefully. I saw first and goal. I didn't look at the score. I thought this was right down on the goal line. And oh, great, we got a chance for a touchdown, right? Well, no, I get out here and I realize that this was an extra point. We should have been kicking the extra point. Instead, I lined us up for a two-point conversion. And by the time I figured out what was going on, yeah, well, this didn't work. I cost us a point. My bad right there by not reading the situation. Although, with this brand new ticker and everything set up a little different, I'm still getting used to the situation like down and distance and all that stuff. It's a little confusing. I'll show another instance of that in a minute here. So here's a kickoff right after that. The Cleveland Browns scored on a drive, got a field goal to make it 10-6. So we down that one. And out comes the offense again. Let's see if we get out there. We're almost to halftime, and it's 12-10 now. So I should have once again realized that this is a two-point conversion. So I set it up here thinking, oh, yeah, that's good. We'll take it back. I'm not even on the field right now. Blanchflower is on the sidelines because of the set I picked. And they're able to get the two-point conversion. So we do get those extra points back, or that extra point that we left on the table earlier. We get it back and make it a 14-10 game. However, they want to do a booth review here. Okay, well, let's see what this looks like. I don't think I've seen a booth review yet. Want to see, well, actually, maybe I saw one other while I was playing. The presentation looks nice on the challenge screen. This is pretty good. Did he have both feet in bounds? That's what we're waiting to find out. And they're going to go ahead and what are they going to say here? Referee says play stands. So there you go. And then we score again, and we're out here for an extra point. So I finally got the extra point situation read correctly, and we get it right there. So Cleveland scores again. It's now 21-17. We have a kickoff. See Blanchflower blocking way upfield there, engaging his guy pretty nicely. Doesn't really result in a return here. And here we go. Second half kickoff. Yeah, lots of kickoffs, guys. So this is what we need to talk about in this series. Do you want to see this go to auto starter? Hold that thought for a second. He's actually on the field for a play. Let's see if he can make a catch here. He's calling for the ball. Roethlisberger, oh, now he throws it. Cut up field. I didn't think he was throwing to me. And then he throws the ball. A little miscommunication right there. We didn't make the most of our situation of being on the field. And now it's back to fielding kickoffs as Cleveland now takes the lead 24-21. So the question I was posing is, do we want to see this go to auto starter when we get the full retail copy of the game here? And moving forward in the series, we have one of two ways to go. We can do that, or we can really make him earn getting on the field. Now, if we continue to make him earn it here, as in working up the chain from third string, and I'll show the depth chart. Actually, I don't know if I got the depth chart in here. He's a 67 overall, and I think the second string tight end is about a 74, so it's going to be slow going. You know, how do we want to handle episodes of this if he is going to work his way up? Because it's going to be a lot of what you see right now. Extra points and kickoff returns, basically, is what he's doing. And he gets on the field once in a while. But I do realize that that doesn't make for extremely compelling YouTube videos. So, I mean, it just depends on the level of realism you want. I will kind of let it be up to you guys in the comments. I'll kind of take an indirect poll. Maybe we'll even throw up a Polestar poll. Or a poll code, whatever you call them, and put a code up here for you guys to vote on, because I think it's kind of important. I mean, I will go with what the audience wants to see more or less here. We can make him an auto starter. Obviously, that'll be a little more fun, not as realistic, but maybe a little more fun. You know, we kind of got to weigh that. So anyway, here is a play that he's out there for, but they're not going to throw his way. He's got another one right here. Let's see if he can get in the mix. Oh, he threw to him, but he overthrew him. You see, that's kind of new there, that the receiver will actually throw his arm out there for a pass that's kind of out of the way, trying to snag it. Kind of a cool animation there. It's too bad they couldn't hook up for a connection right there, Roethlisberger and Blanchflower, but there you go. Cleveland comes in here and wins on the initial week one game here. They come in and get a road victory. So unfortunately, that's not what we were looking for. You know, maybe things would have been better if they would have put the beast Rob Blanchflower in there a little more, right? Yeah, I don't know. But I guess let the debate begin. Should he be a starter? Because they lose this game 44-28. So I got two games in this episode. We go on to play the Ravens next. But before we do that, it's a Thursday night game coming up. So we got a short week. We only have 14 points to develop Blanchflower during practice sessions this week. That's kind of interesting. So they don't put the full week's allotment of points if you're playing a short game. That makes sense. Not as much development time. So you see they keep the running tally there of what he's earned XP-wise on each one of those occasions. So we're going to put this into consistency because that's one of the ones we can afford. And this game is even condensed a little more here to get things moving along, but basically we come on here into Baltimore hoping to get a road win ourselves, and it's going to be more of the same as far as Rob Blanchflower's playing time. He's going to be out here on kickoff return, hopefully try to get a block. No, he's kind of behind everything right there. Doesn't really get anything going, but okay, so we got a 3-0 game. Oh man, it's 17-0, but we finally score 17-6, and that extra point makes it 17-7 right before halftime. Now we go to the third quarter, still 17-7. He's out there for a route, and Roethlisberger's not going to throw him the ball. And did he get that one? I don't know. Yeah, it looks like the drive continues. Now this pass is going to be short again. As you saw, Blanchflower was going deeper on that route. Now he's going to come across the middle, and he throws to him, but he throws behind him. Oh, shoot. He might have gotten a hand on this. Look at this. Zipped it. Look at him try to reach back. No, that was the defender that got a hand on it. So again, they don't connect, but they do end up getting a touchdown here. 20-14 after this extra point. There's still a little life left. Can they come back and win the game? We'll have to see here. The Steelers putting themselves in a bad position once again. Now they're down 9 after a field goal and under 2 minutes remaining. They're going to down that one in the end zone. Will there be a comeback? Well, they definitely don't throw their third string tight end out there for a 2 minute drill, as that's just not going to happen. And they don't get the comeback done either. They were down 9. You needed 2 possessions. It wasn't going to happen. So we fall to 0-2 after losing to the Ravens. This is a tough start. And this is a pretty good time to say this. Is it time for a change at tight end? Do they need to work in a man named Rob Blanchflower in the starting lineup? I don't know. I'm going to leave that up for you guys. I'm going to let you vote. Does Blanchflower get into the starting lineup by way of auto starter? Do we go ahead and do it? Or do we keep doing what's meant to be done here and building him up? Like I said, he's a 67. He's got to get to roughly 74 overall. And he hasn't moved a tick yet. He hasn't even moved up to 68 yet. So let's vote. Will he be a starter or not next time? Let me know your thoughts in the comments and in the poll. We'll see you later, guys. Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed the video, go ahead and join the SGU team. Subscribe right here on YouTube to get daily videos from SGU, as well as frequent live streaming events. Give us a follow on Twitter for up-to-the-minute information on channel uploads. And last but not least, check out the SGU Facebook page. So what are you waiting for? Join in on the fun today!